Welcome to Omega Open course. While solving quadratic equations, you have been taught how to find the real roots of quadratic equation from the graph. All you do is draw the graph of the given quadratic expression and find the points where the graph intersects the x-axis. If it intersects x-axis at two points, the quadratic equation has two distinct roots. If both the points of intersection are on the positive side of the x-axis, then both roots are positive. In such case, one root is positive and another negative. In this case, both the roots are negative. When the graph touches x-axis without intersecting it, as in this case, we say that the equation has only one root or that both the roots are equal. But what if the graph does not intersect x-axis at all? In that case, we say that there are no real roots of the equation or the roots are complex. Have you ever wondered how can you find the complex root of a quadratic expression just from its graph? To understand how to do that, let's start with a quadratic expression whose graph is as shown. You will get such a graph for quadratic expression given by y is equal to ax square plus c, where a and c both are positive real numbers. In such case, the graph intersects y-axis at distance c above the origin. To find the complex root, we will have to move to three dimensions. The original x-axis in which we drew the graph is our real axis with positive direction towards right and negative towards left. The axis perpendicular to x-axis as well as y-axis is the imaginary axis with positive direction away from you and negative direction towards you. Let us move around so that we are nearer to the positive direction of the imaginary axis. If any complex number satisfies this equation, then putting that complex number in place of x must make the expression 0. If you put any complex number with real part p and imaginary part q in the expression, we get y is equal to a into p plus iq square plus c. Simplifying, we get ap square minus aq square plus 2ap into iq plus c. But y has to be 0. Therefore, the expression on the right hand side is 0. This expression can be 0 only when both its real and imaginary part are separately 0. That means 2apq must be 0. But we are finding complex root, therefore q cannot be 0. And hence, if this equation has a complex root, its real part, that is p, must be 0. So our expression reduces to y is equal to minus aq square plus c. Let us plot this graph in the plane formed by y-axis and the imaginary axis. You can see this graph too will intersect the y-axis at distance c above the origin. That is, it will touch the graph we drew on the real axis. The points where this graph intersects the imaginary axis are the complex roots of the given expression. If the point of intersection are at distance b from the origin, then complex roots are ib and minus ib. But this is not fair. I promised you finding solution from the graph of the quadratic expression, not from the three-dimensional graph. Now rotate the graph on the imaginary axis through 90 degrees and align it with the real axis. Now rotate this graph about its vertex by 180 degrees. You will notice that this graph aligns perfectly with the graph on the real axis. As you can see, the imaginary part of the roots are equal to the distance of the points on the parabola at height c from the vertex from y-axis. In other words, mark points on the graph of the expression at height twice the height of the lowest point of the graph. The distance of these points from the y-axis gives the imaginary part of the roots. But what about quadratic expressions that are not in the form of y is equal to ax square plus c but still have complex roots? Let there be a general quadratic expression y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c, where a and c are greater than 0. It is necessary for a and c to be of same sign, because if they are of opposite sign, then the discriminant b square minus 4ac becomes positive and the equation always has real roots. Now take a common to write a into x square plus b by a into x plus c. Now add and subtract b square by 4a square inside the bracket. These terms make a perfect square and this reduces to a into x plus b by 2a whole square plus c minus b square by 4a. This expression has complex root only when c is greater than b squared by 4a. Let's write this term as a new constant small c. A into x plus b by 2a whole square can be written as a into x minus h whole square, where h is minus of b by 2a. Thus, all quadratic expressions can be reduced to the form a into x minus h whole square plus c. If c is negative, this equation has real roots, and if it is positive, then roots are complex. If c is exactly 0, then the root is h, that is minus b by 2a. You might remember from your coordinate geometry class that whenever you replace x by x minus h in equation of any curve, it does not change the shape of the curve. It simply translates it by distance h in positive direction of x-axis when h is positive, and in the other direction if it is negative. For example, the equation x square plus y square is equal to 4 represents a circle with radius 2 and center at the origin. If x is replaced by x minus 3 in this expression, to write x minus 3 whole square plus y square is equal to 4, then this equation simply represents a circle translated by 3 units in positive direction. Now, if you replace y by y plus 1, then this circle will translate towards negative y direction by 1 unit without affecting the shape of the curve. You can extend this idea to 3 dimensions, meaning if you take equation of any surface and replace x by x minus h, then that surface will translate towards positive direction of x-axis without changing the shape or size of the curve. Thus, when we replace our equation with the new equation, that is a into x minus h square plus c, the graph, both on the real and imaginary axis, translates in the direction of x-axis without changing the shape of the graph. If h is positive, it will translate towards the right, and if it is negative, it will move towards left. There is no change in the shape of the curve, it is only moving along the x-axis. Such transformations will not change the imaginary part of the root. It will only change the real part of the root to h from its original value of 0. Thus, to summarize, if you want to find the complex roots of quadratic equation from the graph, first plot the graph of the given quadratic expression. You will get a parabola. If the parabola intersects or touches the axis of x, then it has real roots, and the real roots are the point of intersection or the point of contact of the parabola and the x-axis. If the graph does not intersect the x-axis, then draw a vertical line passing through the vertex of the parabola. The value of x where this line intersects the x-axis gives the real part of the root. Now draw a horizontal line at height twice the height of the vertex from the x-axis. Draw vertical lines from these points of intersections to intersect x-axis. The distance of these points from the real part of the root gives you the imaginary part of the root. If the leading coefficient of your quadratic expression is negative, then you get an inverted parabola. But the steps to find the real and imaginary parts remain the same. Check out the playlist shown on your screen to watch similar videos. Like and share the video and subscribe the channel. Press the bell icon to get notifications of our latest uploads. Like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter. Thank you for watching.